Hey guys, we're starting with my bare face, and today we're using all organic and cruelty-free products from LeBlanc's Beauty and Sensation. This is their small ultra healing BB cream. The regular size is bigger than this, and what I like about this is that they have 9 shades which are perfect for Asian skin tones. I'm in the shade LB02 and it's for a neutral skin with a yellow undertone. Oh, it smells very nice and it is a highly formulated BB for very sensitive skin. This product has full coverage and it can cover all imperfections caused by acne, zit, and acne scars. I'm also using it as a concealer because it has very full coverage and it's lightweight, so I like it under my eyes. And then here I'm also using the same product for highlighting the high points of my face, like under my eyes, nose bridge, chin, and forehead. This technique will give your face some depth and dimension to prevent it from looking flat, so yeah, it's just kind of like a 3D effect. If you want more coverage, I suggest using this Mineral Loose foundation because it also has very good coverage. It is a foundation after all. I'm in the shade Simply Fair and here, I'm using it to set everything we just did earlier. It looks like I'm baking, but it's not actually baking since I won't let it stay for a long time. It's a little bit hard to get it with my sponge because it's very finely milled, but that's okay because it looks really nice on my face. It doesn't look powdery, in fact, it has a very velvety kind of finish to it. For brows, I'm using this Eyebrow Pro Powder in the shade Choco Brown, and seriously guys, a little bit goes a long way with this product. Actually, just like any other LeBlanc product, a little goes a long way, that's why it's worth it. I always start with outlining the shape of my brows. Remember to do this very carefully and then fill it in. I like my brows to have an ombre effect to them, you know, light to dark, and then use a spoolie to blend. Let me show it again one more time in case you didn't get it, so just outline, fill in, then blend. Using the same powder for my brows, I'll use this to do a very natural eyeshadow because girls, sometimes we gotta work with what we have. Using this eyeshadow brush, I'm placing that on the outer corners of my eyes and slowly bringing it in. I'm also doing a circular motion to blend harsh edges, and then with this crease brush, I'm using the same powder and just placing that in the outer V to add depth and dimension to my eyes. This brush will give a darker brown color to this look, that's why using different brush is essential in applying eyeshadows because it makes a different effect depending on the type of brush you use. Now I'm using a curler for my lashes. It's best to curl your lashes while moving it in an upward motion like what I'm doing here. Just me and this one. It'll give you a beautiful kind of curl instead of just making your eyelashes stand up. You guys know me, I'm a sucker for blushes and this color is the bomb. This is their cream cheek blush and it's in the shade Exotic Peach. I totally forgot that it was a cream blush. I know I should have applied it before powder, but because of that, I found out that it's still very pretty even after I applied powder. In fact, I like it even more this way because the blush itself gives a luminous sheen to my cheeks. I also applied that to my nose just to give me a sun-kissed kind of look. I can't decide what color I want for my lips, so I have 3 lip shades to show you, and the first one is a liquid lipstick in the shade Freya. This is the old packaging, and here's the new packaging. I really like the gold and glass packaging of this. It looks like a high-end liquid lipstick. It's also very easy to apply because of its applicator, and you don't need a lip liner for this one. Plus, you only need one swipe to achieve this color. Next up, we have a matte lipstick called Push Me, and it's a very beautiful nude color. Again, one swipe will give you the color that you want. LeBlanc makes one of my favorite lipstick formulas because I have very dry lips, but their lipsticks don't crumble and make my lips dry. Last but not least, I have here their new formula for matte lipsticks and it's in the shade Shannon. Rarely do I pick colors like this, but this one is just so pretty. I mentioned new formula because they made it creamy so it glides smoothly and it's now a little bit transfer proof. There you have it. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye!